My name is Brett Remmer.
And I'm Bryce Burnham.
And welcome to the Friday Show. If it's not Friday when you're watching this, we don't care.
We want to start this episode by shouting out to our sponsor, iApple. This is the brand new iApple 7. Great product. Okay, now our first story today is a very serious one. It's about a controversial topic. So let's take a look.
Today, we ask students the age-old question, can I get a dab? With Brett Remmer.
Can I get a dab?
Can I get a dab?
That is Can I Get a Dab with Brett Remmer.
Thank you, Brett, for clearing that up.
Thank you. Recently, with the death of Supreme Court Justice Antonin Scalia, the election season has gained a new complication. Our reporter Brandon Berman reports.
Antonin Gregory Scalia was an Associate Justice of the Supreme Court of the United States from 1986 until his death on February 13, 2016. Appointed to the court by Ronald Reagan in 1986, with his death, the court is split between four liberal judges and four conservative judges, and the next appointee is going to be the tiebreaker. History teacher Mr. Verhoeven gives his perspective.
Generally, you're going to find Democrats are going to choose more liberal justices and conservatives are going to choose, Republicans are going to choose more conservative justices. So the fact that we currently have a Democrat in office, which would imply we'll have a more liberal justice chosen, has infuriated the other side because they would like to wait and see if they might win the White House, that they could choose one.
Due to the untimely death of Scalia, Barack Obama has to face the problem of nominating a new justice, which has to take a while to process for the nomination of a new justice to be passed. With the election, the Republicans want to stop Obama and wait for the new appointment on the next president.
Justices are chosen by the president, as laid out in the Constitution. Once the president has nominated somebody, it goes to the Senate Judiciary Committee. They then will decide if they support that candidate and will then recommend him to the full Senate, and then the full Senate has to have a vote. If at least half of the senators vote for him, then that person is appointed for the rest of their life to the United States Supreme Court.
Now that President Obama has nominated Merrick B. Garland to fill the Supreme Court vacancy, it will be a hard fight to get him confirmed. I am Brandon Berman, reporting for Redlands High News.
Thank you, Brandon, for explaining what is at stake this election season.
And now to take a look at the government here at RHS. Kenneth Zuniga takes a look at ASB.
We recently interviewed Ms. Bill, who's one of the advisors for ASB, and she told us what ASB is.
ASB stands for Associated Student Body, and Associated Student Body is any student at Redlands High School. Student government is the leadership class that has been elected or appointed to make decisions for the Associated Student Body.
We also spoke to a few of the members of the leadership class to tell us what their positions and duties are.
Hi, what's your name?
Hermier.
What do you do, Hermier?
I'm the junior class president.
What are some of your duties as the junior class president?
We take care of prom and fundraise.
During our interview, we asked Ms. Beal, what is the purpose of ASB?
Purpose for student government is to come up with all the events and activities, a lot of the fun stuff, the support activities, getting people to go to the games, handing out academic patches, that type of thing. They handle all of that.
And we also asked her, how can we improve ASB?
Just get involved in something, anything, whether it's a club or go to a dance or go to the water polo game after school, because that helps ASB student government decide what they're going to do to bring opportunities to the student body.
Make sure you get involved in ASB. I'm Kenneth Zuniga, reporting for Redlands News. Thanks for watching.
Thank you, Kenneth, for that look at our student government and seeing how it operates.
Up next, a quick commercial break.
I am sane. I like to drink coffee in the morning. I like to wave at people and wish them a beautiful day. I leave my toilet seat up for my wife.
I am insane. I like to stuff empty pillowcases with dead chickens and cuddle with them at night. I like to dress up as little girls. I like to stick my fingers in my ears until the loud ringing is all I hear.
Welcome back. Now, we're going to talk about the cheerleader selection process here at RHS. Jose Marquez reports.
Cheerleading is one of many sports programs at RHS. Lori Henderson, the varsity cheerleading coach, gives us some information on how she became a cheer coach.
I was a cheerleader in high school, and then when I got married and had children, I was a stay-at-home mom. Came to work at Redlands High School, and there was an opening for a cheer coach, so I thought that it would be really fun to do. My biggest challenge for coaching is actually trying to get all of the girls with their different personalities to mesh and to work well together.
You can try out for next year's team, as Lori Henderson explains.
If they want to become a cheerleader, song leader, mascot, that is happening soon. March 31st is a mandatory parent meeting that anybody is welcome to come to. We give them all the information, and our tryouts are April 20th.
Last year, our cheerleaders won CIF championships. CIF stands for the California Inter-Scholarship Federation.
It's really hard to win nationals. We are always against many, many teams, and so it just all depends on how they get out there on the floor and perform in front of the huge arena of people.
I'm Jose Marquez for Redlands High News.
Thank you to this year's cheerleaders and mascots, and good luck to those trying out next year. The bar is set high.
Now for the premiere of the dramatic thriller, Condor. Enjoy.
Just my luck. Looks like my computer's in trouble. Guess I'll have to find a new one.
Take mine. I'm done, and this one's working fine.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Freeze! Get on the ground! Hands behind your head! Get on your knees!
Yeah, what he said.
This is the Major.
This is Condor. We have a problem. We need to abort. I repeat, we need to abort.
The bomb is in the closet. Disarm it now. You have less than a minute. Good luck, Condor.
Wait, how do I disarm the bomb? Hello? Hello?
Thank you.
You know you're in there. Come out with your hands up.
Don't take it serious. It's too mysterious. You think, you save, you worry so. But you can't take your dough when you go, go, go. Keep repeating, it's the berries, the strongest dough.
I really hope our school doesn't explode. I'm Brett Rimmer.
And I'm Bryce Burnham. If you've stayed this long, until next time, Terriers, have a great day. Thank you for watching.
All the old paintings on the tomb, they do the sand dance, don't you know? If you move too quick, away, they're falling down like a domino. On a bed called crocodiles, oh, hey, oh. They snap their teeth on your cigarette, falling tight to the hookah.